Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a prayer that will make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction, oh beautiful wrist. Memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty, oh and weightless, and maybe you'll find some peace tonight in the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room, and the endlessness that you feel. You are pulled from the wreckage.
So tired of the straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. The storm keeps on twisting, keep on building the lies that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. In this sweet madness, oh, this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees. In the arms of the angel, fly away from here, from this dark.
Better known as Miss Cathy. Brothers and sisters, can we be quiet, please, so you can listen to the eulogy? Catherine Bastien, better known as Miss Cathy, was born and raised in Demuin, the only daughter of four children of the late Irene Bastien. Miss Cathy was the mother of six boys and three girls. She always said to them, "I am the mother and the father. I know how to add, subtract, multiply and divide. because I have to know how to spend the little money that I have to take care of all of you. Her children would laugh whenever she said this. In all her struggles, she never forgets about God. She was always attending church service and was a member of the church choir from a very early age. The tone of her voice was captivating. Miss Cathy was very jovial and would respond, "Sweetheart," to everyone's greeting. One day, the parish priest visited her home to administer Holy Communion. The priest greeted her, "Good morning, my friend," and she responded in a loud voice, "Good morning, sweetheart." Everyone bursted into laughter, including the priest. Anytime a person asked her for something, she would say, "Mwevle." But we still hand it to you and love to share whatever she had and stay without. For example, she would have the only $5 and would give it away to someone. Open the gates of heaven for you, and may your soul rest in peace. The words of a friend, Hermina Frederick, that Miss Cathy, among the treasure women upon whose shoulder I stand, at her footstool, the many puzzles of teenager life became sparkling clear. I drew deeply from her store of knowledge and wisdom. Whenever I came home on vacation, I had to visit Miss Cathy. We would part with her telling me that I might not see her next time. So on my next visit, it was with great joy that I tell her, "See, you're still there." After hearing of her passing, a quiet twinge of sadness ran through me. Farewell, Miss Cathy. Blessed are you among women.
Okay, so these are words from Mama's goddaughter. Her name is Agnes Peter Keen, better known as Mimin. Never say goodbye. There can be no goodbyes for us. It would be too painful, godmother. Our connection still lives on. Although you're far from here, I miss the times that we once had. But one day, once again, I'll hold you close and laugh with you. I just wish I knew when, each moment, I just wish I knew when. Each moment till that day arrives, until my time is through, I'll miss you more than words can say, and I'll always think of you. I'll look for you among the stars and each dawn's pastel sky, and the whisper words of love to you. Rest in peace, Godmother. I pray you are blessed by the words of this song.
To help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who lost their way. There's a place for people like you. I've heard out there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. When your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you try to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love, so someone could be saved. There's a place up there for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
We will now join in singing our entrance hymn, God Gives His People Strength.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Catherine Bastin, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. We will listen to the readings. The first reading is from Isaiah chapter 25, verses 6 to 9.
The word of the Lord. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord Sabaoth will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
We will join in singing the responsorial psalm, "The Lord's My Shepherd." The second reading is from a letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 31 to 39.
I wrote it.
With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain after such a gift that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No, he only died for us. He rose from the dead, and there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can come between us and the love of Christ, even if we are troubled or worried or being persecuted or lacking food or clothes or being threatened or even attacked. These are the trials through which we triumph by the power of Him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death, nor life, no angel, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love of God made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Let's all stand for the proclamation of the good news. Die with Christ, we shall live with Him, and if we are faithful to the end, we shall reign with Him.
Alleluia, alleluia, Jesus is the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ is
the Lord. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 PM, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last. Now there was a virtuous and righteous man named Joseph, who, though he was a member of the council, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. After he had taken the body down, he wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb in which no one had yet been buried. The Gospel of the Lord. Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. On behalf of this parish, I extend my heartfelt condolences and comfort and sympathy to the bereaved family of our sister Catherine. We all of us know the truth: death is inevitable and natural, but we don't know when is our time. When the people die and go before us, in a way they taught a legacy, or they keep their own legacy of life behind, that we may follow them or we may learn from them. But one way or other, they try to teach us something after their death. And today we are gathered here in this holy church to commemorate or celebrate the life of our sister Catherine, well lived here on earth. Now, according to our Christian faith, she is going to meet the Lord face to face. And we know, my brothers and sisters, everyone wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die. That is the reality of life. And we, all of us, have a struggle here on earth. And when we live, we need to live for Christ. When we die, we need to die for Christ, said by St. Paul. Because we, all of us, especially the Christians, were baptized in Jesus Christ, then we also will die in Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ and Master died on the cross for our sins, and he also justified after coming back to life after 3 days in the tomb. And that shows that he not only preached, but he lived, or he told us what he wanted to do. And in the history of any religion, when we study, we don't find the reality of life as that of Jesus than anybody else in this world. We the Christians need to be proud of our Master, our Lord Jesus Christ. In a way, he wanted to prove his love. He was trying, but he was not able to prove his love unless he embraced his death on the cross. And again, he wanted to prove his own everlasting love, coming back to life. And that's how all the disciples of Jesus Christ, especially the apostles, could go nook and corner of the world to preach the good news in the name of the Trinity. And they were courageous and brave after the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. That shows when somebody like our sister Catherine dies, they also waiting for their own resurrection. She was baptized in this church, and she also will rise. But depends on our own prayers that we pray for her. Yes, Maria Bas and sisters, every time we need to experience our faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. He came back to life, and that is how we offer a liturgical service or a mass for the bereaved or the deceased one. Because we believe in our Lord Jesus Christ, the death and resurrection, and that is how all those who go before us definitely will reach to heaven, and we pray for them. In the life of Job, who said, "Naked I came to this world, naked I shall return. Whatever I heard here on earth, it was given to me, but not my own." But today, we unnecessarily wanted to possess many things. But when we die, we are bare empty. That is the lesson or the legacy that we learn, my dear brothers and sisters. Today, here, we always meet with many difficulties and challenges in our lives. But believing in God and experiencing His one passion, death and resurrection, definitely we are not prepared. That's how the church is overflowing with the crowd when somebody dies. Not in ordinary days, I'm not exaggerating. It is the fact of life. When somebody goes before us, there is a fear of death in every one of us. We cannot deny the fact. We want to live, nobody wants to die. But how we want to live our life? And here, many people, without having aim and goal in the life, take the life of somebody else, and neither they live in peace, nor they let others live in peace. We have only one life. Let us live in accordance with the will of God. Let us try to live in peace. Let us create that good atmosphere of brotherhood among our society. And the death of the person reminds us that nothing is permanent in this world. So, as the children of God, let us live our life worthy of God, for God's love. Our Lord Jesus Christ proved his love on the cross. And today, our sister Catherine has made so much love to all this large congregation. She is not here to witness, but here we are to witness the love that she has for this large gathering. That is the love of person, my dear brothers and sisters. We need to celebrate after the death of each person. So when you and I die, we don't know what would happen, but definitely we will be on the way to resurrection if we believe in our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us try to not create a legacy, but let us keep the legacy behind. The people will learn from that legacy if we were to be good with the people and the society and the community. And may Almighty God give consolation, comfort those who mourn over the death of our sister Catherine, especially the family and friends. May God be your consolation and comfort, and may soothe you, giving all that we need in our life. Let us not forget that we have an obligation to pray for the deceased one, that especially for our sister Catherine. And she needs always our prayers, because the dead person cannot do anything by himself or herself. That is how the congregation, we need to take that pledge that we are here to pray for you. That's what during the service or during the Holy Eucharist, we have the memorial service or memorial mass in order to commemorate or celebrate the life of the person every time. Today we may bury her, but she lives in the hearts of many. Let us remember and thank God for the life given to our sister Catherine. And now also we also have that firm faith in the intercession of our saints and the angels, and she is going to be in one among them. She is going to be in the company of angels and saints to intercede for us. Let us invoke the presence of God through her intercession. May God continue to grant her eternal bliss, and to all of us, comfort and consolation. May her soul rest in peace.
Please stand for the prayers of the faithful.
My dear brothers and sisters, ask that you may receive is guaranteed by our Lord Jesus Christ. Having this in our minds and hearts, let us pray. For a response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister Catherine Bastin, let us pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for our sister Catherine Bastin, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Especially we pray for the congregation which gathered here to mourn the death of our sister Catherine. Give consolation and comfort, especially to the family of our sister Catherine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we especially pray for our church and the leaders of our church. Bless our Holy Father Francis, our Archbishop Gabriel, the clergy, religious and the laity, that you may continue to be firm in following your footsteps as your true disciples. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we do pray for our nation, St. Lucia, and the leaders of our country. Lord, give prosperity and peace to our nation. May the civil leaders be instilled in their minds and hearts to promote peace and justice to this nation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now let us pray in silence for our own needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us submit all our prayers and petitions into the hands of our Blessed Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. God, our loving Father, as we have expressed all our prayers and petitions in faith, listen to them, Lord, graciously. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. We will now have our special collection to assist with parish projects. During that time, we will sing Blessed Assurance. Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine! A salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. Submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture burst on my soul. Echoes of mercy, whispers of love. Stand for the Our Father.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring me everlasting life.
We will now have communion. You can be seated. Those of us who are prepared, you will come in front of the casket. Father will stand in front of the casket, and you will receive communion on your hands. During that time, we will sing, "I am the bread of life." For the prayer after communion.
Lord God, your Son Jesus Christ gave us the sacrament of his body and blood to guide us on our pilgrim way to your kingdom. May our sister Catherine Bastin, who shared in the Eucharist, come to the banquet of life of Christ has prepared for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. We will now have the signing of the register. Four witnesses, please come up. During that time, we will have a special rendition. Witnesses, Winston Bastien, Octave Bastien, Oswald Bastien, and Carolina Bastien. Please stand for the blessing.
My dear brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Catherine Bassin. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
We will join in singing "Because He Lives."
They called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon and empty
Our response, receive her soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid, hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Catherine, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to the place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Our sister Catherine has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together, may we meet Jesus Christ when he who is our life appears in glory. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all those who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection even as it climbs our mortal bodies. As we lay our sister into this tomb, bless this tomb as she is going to take rest to be risen. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our sister Catherine from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her body on the last day. Let us pray. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant, Catherine Bastin. Do not count her deeds against her, for in his heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. We will join in singing our recessional hymn, Mweka Mute.
Mm-hmm. guess it's me again. But I didn't call this time to get forgiveness for myself. I called to talk to Mama, and I know she's there with you. If there's a fall in heaven, then Jesus put me through.
Cross, so despised by the world, has has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross to my trophy.
It is well. So let go. Yeah. It must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You are content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, and you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long, beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I can fly higher than an eagle. You are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth, of course I know it. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be.
You gave me a drawer in your kitchen. You gave me the room with a view of the yard. Whatever the hurt, you knew right where to kiss it. You gave me the best of your heart. And you carried my rocks in your pocket. Flowers and feathers and butterfly wings. You had an answer for all of my questions. You showed me wonderful things. I know that it hasn't been easy. I hope that I love like you do, 'cause I know that this world would be better if everyone had a mother like you. You make the best macaroni. We never cared that it came from a box. The mom in the stands always clapping her hands, started cheering, and still haven't stopped. And you held me when I came home crying, 'cause someone said something that just wasn't true. I always said that Janelle was my best friend, but really, it's always been you. I know that I haven't been easy. I hope that I love like you do, 'cause I know that this world would be better if everyone had a mother like you. Our second was born in September. I still can't believe I have kids of my own. I look in their eyes and I can't help but wonder, who will they be when they're grown? I know it won't always be easy. I hope I can love like you do, 'cause I know that my kids will be better if they have a mother like you. If I am a mother like you, 'cause I had a mother like you.
on my There is an answer. Someday we will know, and you will ask her why she had to go. We live and die, we laugh and we cry. You must take away the pain before you can begin to live again. So let it start, my friend, let it start. Let the tears come rolling from your heart. And when you need a light in the lonely nights, carry me like a fire in your heart. Carry me like a fire in your heart. There is a river shadows disappear. Yes, let it start, my friend, let it start. Let the love come rolling from your heart. And when you need a light in the lonely nights, carry me like a fire in your heart.
Alright, this is Here Comes Goodbye, you guys.
Well, I can hear the truck tires coming up the gravel road. And it's not like her to drive that slow, and nothing's on the radio. Footsteps on the front porch. Now I hear my doorbell. She usually comes right in. No, I can't tell. Here comes goodbye. Here comes the last time. Here comes the start of every every sleepless night, the first of every tear I'm gonna cry. Here comes the pain, here comes me wishing things had never changed, and she was right here in my arms tonight. Here comes goodbye. I can hear her say I love you like it was yesterday, and I can see it written on her face that she had never felt this way. One day I thought I'd see her with her daddy by her side, and violins would play. Goodbye. Here comes the last time. Here comes the start of every sleepless night. The first of every tear I'm gonna cry. Here comes the pain. Here comes me wishing things had never changed. And she was right here in my. Here comes goodbye. Why's it have to go from good to gone before the lights turn on and you're left alone? All alone. But here comes goodbye. Here comes the last time. Here comes the start of every sleepless night, the first of every tear I'm gonna cry. Here comes the pain. Here comes me wishing things had never changed. She was right here in my heart.
losing the beat.
If you give a little more than you take, if you try to fit more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up, put those down on their knees, and lend a voice to those who cannot speak. If you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who lost the way. There's a place for people. You want to see. If you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Our Father, there's a street made of gold.
Must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You are content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, and you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I can fly high.
'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Of course I know it. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I can fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. Did I ever tell you you're my hero? You're everything, everything I wish I could be. I can fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my You are the wind beneath my wings.
Garden with angels. angels singing on a cloudy bandstand. Up in heaven, in the garden, won't you take my mama there by the hand?
A lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete someday must leave, must say goodbye.
Someday you'll see. last time I will hold you near. Someday I'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say goodbye. Till we meet again, until then, goodbye.
Breath that I a well of tears. Vain is this world, Lord, I now resign. Lord,
give me a heart like thine.
Lord, and hatch you to come to my soul.
My soul, blessed Jesus.
Hear me, O Savior divine.
Hear me, O Savior divine.
Open the fountain and cleanse me.
Open the fountain and cleanse me.
Blessed Jesus.
Blessed Jesus.
Hear me, O Savior divine.
Hear me,
hey,
O Savior divine.
Open the fountain and cleanse me.
Open the fountain and cleanse me.
Secret place where the sound of the crowd is so far away, and you take my hand, and it feels like home. We both understand it's where we belong. So how do I say goodbye? Have our dreams, we both wanna fly. So let's take tonight to carry us through the lonely times.
I'll always look back as I walk away. This memory will last for eternity.
But no matter.